introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year. Stole many a man's soul and faith. I was around when Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain. Me damn sure the pilot washed his hands and sealed his face. Pleased to meet you, hope you guessed my name. But what's puzzling you is the nature of my game. Stuck around St. Petersburg when I saw it was a time for change. Killed the Tsar and his ministers. Anastasia screamed in vain. I rode a tank, held a generous rank. When the blitzkrieg raged and the bodies stank. Pleased to meet you, hope you guessed my name. Oh yeah, I was puzzling you with the nature of my game. Oh yeah, I watched with glee while your kings and queens fought for tender cakes for the gods they made. I shouted out, who killed the Kennedys? When after all, it was you and me. Let me please introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I lay traps for troubadours who get killed before they reach Bombay. Pleased to meet you, hope you get my name. Oh yeah. But what's puzzling you is the nature of my name. Oh yeah, get down in it.
Selling genre of music changed since the business first opened?
Yeah, so over 28 years the shop's been here. It was up until sort of the onslaught of the digital revolution with DJs.
Yeah.
So before that, predominantly stuff that sold was dance, vinyl,
yeah,
house, techno, that sort of thing, funk records, 70s funk, that was the predominant the driver of the shop. And everybody wanted to be a DJ, everybody had turntables, everybody DJed with records, so
yeah,
and everybody was buying them, so it was always demand outstripped supply.
Alright.
Then what happened was the digital revolution happened with DJs, so people started playing CDs, now they play USBs, you know what I mean? So that demand for that kind of thing really dropped off in the sort of 2004, 2005, it started, took a massive dip. This was still just before the resurgence of people wanting to buy records. So
yeah,
then in the last 3 years, maybe, especially this year, it's completely switched now, and the main sellers is on the rock side, so it's in indie. But then also big rock bands, Led Zeppelin, Pink Floyd, everybody wants to own them. That's where it's gone. Heavy metal,
yeah,
that's gone. Dance music's come back a little bit. It's more of a collector's market, and there's like labels that do little tiny presses and do vinyl only releases. So there's a little market there. That has crept up a little bit as well. But now, I'd say it's definitely rock and dance, rock and pop rather than the main seller.
Most of the people that come in collectors.
Again, it's changed. It used to be because you know people, everyone's going, had a bit of an idea, they were quite clued up. Now it's just everyone's got right. You've got people who never owned a record, never owned a turntable, you know, these kids that have grown up with CDs and downloads, so they don't really have much of a clue. They're learning, which, you know, you can't, I'm not criticising them. So there is a lot of novices as well now, yeah.
Shops looked.
Yeah, I mean, it got refurbed about 18 months ago after looking like, well, upstairs got redone, it must be 10 years ago now, so that's looking a bit shabby now, but and down here got redone probably 18 months ago.
Yeah.
Before that, it was like those strip lights there, it was horrible. It was like being in a really shit doctor's surgery. It just looked nasty.
Yeah.
It took us like three years to convince the guys that own the shop to actually try and make it look a bit more presentable. I think we pulled it off. So.
That's all right. Do you find that there is a common type of character that shop is?
not particularly. I mean, you get people who, you get know-it-alls. You know, they're your collectors. They've been around for ages. You know, I think they know everything. You get your mentals that come in every week, you know, and we're quite friendly with a lot of them. We don't discourage anyone from coming in, and we don't judge anyone. You know, some of them buy records, some of them just slack a bit of a daycare place, they come in and say hello and we have a laugh with them. We just treat them like normal people, and I think they like that. Yeah. You know, a lot of shops just won't have it. Mm. So, you know, they come in and see us and we have a laugh with them, and then they go on the way. And then, you know, you've just got, yeah, it's a broad spectrum, really. Yeah, there's not any one type.
Yeah.
You know, it crosses all ages now. You've got loads of kids coming in buying records, which is great, because they're the next generation of buyers, which, you know, without them, once all the old farts die and no one's buying records, it's added. So that's good.
And what's it like to work in an atmosphere like this?
Right, it's not the most professional, it's not HMV, put it that way. So, you know, a lot of goofing around goes on, and, you know, it's just like, one lad left and said it was like working in a garage, but it's great. It's just very relaxed, which is good. I mean, you don't get a lot of shops like that now.
Yeah.
But it's got to be. It's just the way the shop runs. It works well for us, really.
It's what makes it. It's what makes
it. But it's, I think it's got a friendly atmosphere to it. It's like, we're not robots, you know. We've all got personalities, and, you know, a lot of us have worked here. Worked in other shops and stuff. You know, I've worked in record shops since 1986, so it's like I've got 30 years under my belt, and most of the other lads that have as well, we've got like 10, 15, 20 years record shop experience, so we all know what we're talking about, you know.
Yeah.
Mm. So, well, we think we do.
That's everything. Thank you very much.
Cheers.